Brandon Harris of Miami, Florida, also had a very nice day.
Great day.
Also,
I agree with Brandon Harris. I mean, it's not what I heard, it's what I saw with my own eyes.
Right.
This guy's footwork is unbelievable. He was slow, he was patient, he was calm. He came out his breaks with explosion, then his hand and eye coordination was impeccable. The guy had a great day.
Now, I get on the edge when people start, you know, talking about things like that. You know, you're not the biggest guy. How are you going to cover those big receivers? I'll practice that part of the game. You know, I've faced bigger receivers all my life. I've always been considered a smaller player. But yet, year in and year out, I've always been able to be productive in my position, no matter who I was covering and things like that. I learned from my mistakes, and when I'm going against the bigger guys, obviously it's a different technique than when you're playing the small, quicker guys in the slot. So it's definitely a bit of transition, but it's not something that's new to me. Coming from an area where I always had to up my game no matter what level I played on. I think I'm very versatile, and I love the game of football. It's not just something that I do just to do. You know, I was born into this game, and I think my love for the game and my passion when I play the game, I think it separates me from a lot of people. And I'm able to do a lot of things on the football field. Like Miami, they played me in the slot a lot, and they also played me outside at corner. So I was able to move around and make a lot of plays, and, you know, being able to blitz from the outside and also cover guys man-to-man in the slot. You know, I was able to do a lot of things that they wanted me to do.
Anybody in the league today whose game you model yourself after, like you would closely compare yourself to?
Yes, sir. I try to mimic my game a lot, as close as possible to Charles Woodson, because, you know, he's one of the corners that I watch, and he does a lot of I do a lot of the similar things he does as far as playing the outside corner position and then, you know, certain packages, bouncing inside to the nickel and coming off the edge, blitzing the quarterback and being able to stick your nose in there and make a tackle in the run game. And I think as a DB, that's the quality that you have to have in the National Football League. You have to be able to tackle just as well as you can cover.
You're not a big receiver, a big quarterback. I mean, what do you think the best part of your game? Playing off or getting up in the receiver phase of the ball?
Me being what they consider a smaller cornerback, I think it helps me to have come from a system like Miami where I was able to still be aggressive and be physical with some of those bigger receivers that, you know, a lot of them don't expect guys of my size to be able to do. And I'm very quick in coverage, and I can run with the best of them, but when I'm able to use my feet work at the line and put my hands on guys, that's something that a lot of guys are impressed by when they see me do that, being, you know, I'm not, you know, 6 foot or 6'1" or anything like that. And it just prepared me a long ways in the game of football, playing against a lot of those bigger receivers as I grew up in the ranks.
Here's Harris.
Good transition.
He has great hands, man. His hands are soft. Taught you in college, and who didn't? I mean, some coaches prefer the T-step. Some coaches prefer, we call it the unicycle, which is just continuous movement.
Here's Brandon Harris. He's a unicycle guy.
The combine, Brandon Harris from the U. We just saw him perform nicely out on the field. This is what he did at the 40 earlier today. Times again, all unofficial until the rest of the DBs run their 40s later.
He's had a good day.
Yeah, he was mid 4.4s, I believe, there.
Academy, the Academy, the Academy.
Beat.